Yo, what's up everyone? Today I'm going to be showing a clean ident highlight intro which you can do for all of your Fortnite montages or highlight videos or whatever you want to call it. As it's in the title, it's no plugins, and I'll have the presets used linked in the description for you guys to download, but please make sure to watch the video because not all the effects are linked in the description. Yeah, I have my clip here which I'm just gonna trim down to a point because I don't like being in the car. So just gonna trim it down here. Make sure that your timeline is on 60 frames per second. What I wanna do here is now I wanna drag in my ident. I will have an ident for you guys to use in the description because this is a custom made ident. This is not just something that I can make or template. It's made in After Effects, but I will have one linked in the description for you guys to use for free, of course. Cut your clip where the ident ends. Let's see here. Open retime controls. Oh, sorry, I'm a bit rusty. Make this 50%. This is important. Don't do this. Do this because this is where the clip is lining up. So just like that, and you'll see that it is lined up. Perfect. This is kind of hard to explain, but it looks very good. You want to make this kind of a slow beat drop. It will make the effect look a lot better when we add the shake. So you want to go 15 frames ahead, just press plus on your keyboard, type 15, add speed point, and make this 50%. Just like that. Go to retime curve, just unclick this and click that instead. Press this little dot and press this, and you'll have this kind of graph editor, and just do it however you like. This looks good for me. You'll see that it's kind of slow when the beat drops, which is going to look better with the effect. Now what you want to do is add an adjustment layer. Actually, just push the item up a bit, just like this, and go into the fusion page and add the preset called under item effect, the adjustment layer, and connect the dots. There's no keyframes in this, so this is basically all you have to do. Next thing is in the adjustment layer out here, you want to add an effect called edge detect. Boom. And if you have an RGB item, you can use RGB edges. But if you have a colored item like I do, see, it's kind of like a purple bluish color, change it to grayscale edges. And change this color to the color of your item. So just do, that looks just about right. This, you just want to keep the way it is. And change the global blend to anywhere between 1.3 and 1.5, depending on what looks best. I'm just going to change this to, 1.5 seems good. You can also play a little bit with this. It's not going to do very much, but, you know. Next thing you want to do is go to the clip itself, change the opacity to 75, which is gonna highlight the ident a little bit more itself. Go to the very end, keyframe it, and do, let's say, 25. Go back about 30 frames, I think. Press minus on your keyboard, 30, and then change this to 75 again, so you have nice fade out. Okay, next thing is another effect. Let's see, this should be good. Go in the fusion page again on the top adjustment layer. Wait, there's actually something here I just need to do. Do it like that instead. And make sure you're on the adjustment clip and not the ident, which I apparently am, I think. There we go. Add a transform effect. Go to the very end of the clip. Change the size to 1.25. Keyframe it. Go back about 30 frames. Just about here. Change the size to 1 again. And you'll have nice zoom in build up. Next thing is find these two. Control A and S like we've just done. And you'll get these two. Then just push this forward. Push this backwards. that's gonna create like a more smooth build-up, as you can see. Yep, okay, now you'll have this actually just to like that, so like fades in. That is just perfect, looks good. Add an adjustment layer and make sure that you don't do this when you add the adjustment layer. You want to have this end at the start, because the timeline is not going to work, the preset is not going to work, not going to be lined up. Add the after ident shake, no plugins. Here we go. As you can see, the keyframes are right here, but if they're not lined up, you go into the keyframe tab up here, and they might be over here, they might be over here. You just do this just like that, and you press all of these and control at the same time, so you have them all selected. I just, yeah, do it with all of them and then line them up with this, so you have the first keyframe at the start of the adjustment clip. But hopefully it's gonna wait for you, because it's, yeah, it's kind of annoying. And then you'll have something that looks like this. There's no song, you're gonna have to do that yourself. I didn't want to do that. So you can see that looks pretty good. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Make sure to like and subscribe if you enjoyed this video. Let me know in the comments if I should do more no plugin type of videos, because I don't know how many of you don't have plugins. So yeah, that is pretty much it for today's video. Hope you enjoyed, and I will see you hopefully soon.